our second birthday on Kids Company. And you're invited to the party. And what a party it's going to be too, with Kenny Kittner.
G'day, girls and boys. It's Kids Company. It's Monday. It's our second birthday. Please welcome the rest of the party, Todd Johnston and Amanda Duplett. Happy birthday to us.
Big birthday.
This
it
week.
Is.
Are you excited?
Decorations look good.
Hey, who did the decorations? Hey,
well,
you know?
I had a little bit to do with it, but I think, Kenny, you had a bit to do with it, didn't you?
I had a little bit to do with it, but I had to get someone to hold me up to stick it up there.
Really?
Somebody's short.
And speaking of decorations, let's have a look at the studio audience.
Yes.
Boy, do they look good.
Yes.
Say hello, everybody. Come on. Boy, they just look so decorated. And
they do.
Someone that could possibly do with some tinsel on his face is...
The birthday boy.
Brent.
Ow, what do you mean tinsel on my face? Come on.
Hey, Brent, that's a lovely curtain you're wearing.
Yep, my grandmother sent it to me. I think it's a shirt, really.
Oh, really? Don't call me a really.
Looks like
okay.
A now. You still look like a curtain.
You cheeky guy, Ken.
I'm excited about the second.
What have we got on today's show, eh? What have we got?
We've got Kenny's Wheel.
Yeah.
We've got some great cartoons.
We have got Connect Four and we've got Funny Faces.
Yay.
Oh, there's so much. We've also got audience input where we get jokes and a bit of tomfoolery from the audience. And also... Tomfoolery, you know?
We've got tomfoolery in the show.
No, not tomfoolery, just games and stuff.
Oh, sorry.
And also we have a game called What Is It? But to kick off today's show, now listen, you are the Food Buster mascot.
Official mascot.
Official Food Buster mascot from
Western
Australia.
They're going to strap me to the bonnet of the official car and I'm going to drive around the streets of Perth and wave to everybody.
Yes, and say things like, hey, now listen.
Ticket take parade, hello everybody.
Food Busters is on June 15. And just to introduce you to what Food Busters is all about, I really want you to put your hands together at home, the studio audience, I know that they will, because here is a great act to introduce you to Food Busters. This is called Moving Images. Let's go!
No food. Hey, don't eat your lunch. Hey, give
give up your food and join the gang of Food Busters. And the hunger pains, they don't feel too good. Who you gonna call? Food Busters! I'm afraid of no food. Miss a meal or two. I'm afraid of no food.
That's Moving Images busting out on Kids Company. Don't go away. This is Kids Company, and the party continues with Victor Almoa.
G'day, Kitty Winks. It's Victor's cartoon time. Here come my rocking buddies in, Robin Hulk and he... I don't know what he saw in Maid Wendy. I thought the horse looked better to me. Oh, well, more Kids Company coming up.
Oh, you've got no taste, Victor. We party on with What Is It Next?
Test you. Get ready.
We're back with our second birthday party on Kids Company.
We have got the best studio audience today. They have seen for a long time.
Big and so noisy.
They are.
Well, it is terrific. And of course, they know who they're barracking for. This is the What Is It game. We have two contestants, but the objectives in this game is there are, well, 10 items, hidden items, and we blindfold the contestants.
We do.
Miss Amanda, blindfold them, and if they get the right, we put it in their hand. If they get it right, they get a point. Mm-hmm. And then they have to answer a question. If they get that right, they get a bonus point.
A bonus point.
And what do the prizes look like, Miss Amanda?
The winner today will receive this Hanamex camera.
Ooh.
And a runner-up will be taking home one of these great Milton Bradley games.
Every single Milton Bradley game is a winner. So there you go, Milton Bradley pottery craft. That looks pretty good. Mm. Let's have a look at our contestants.
Our contestants, first Richard. How are you going, Richard?
All right.
And Hayley. Welcome to the show.
Yes, Richard, what school do you go to?
Waddington.
Where's that? You don't even know it. It's the one school he goes to. Richard, I wish you the best in this competition, mate. Okay, and young Hayley, what school do you go to?
North Innaloo.
North Innaloo, and that's in North Innaloo, isn't it?
It's in Innaloo.
Yes, I knew that. Okay, let's check those blindfolds. Come on, Miss Amanda.
Would you like to put your blindfolds on? I think they can do it by themselves.
Now, studio audience, no yelling out. This is a competition here between two people.
Well, there you go, Hayley. Nice and tight. Okay, we'll just do the little test. Can you see how many fingers I'm holding up?
That's correct.
Okay, that's right. Yay. Hayley? How many fingers am I holding up?
I can't see.
Aha, she's okay.
Either that or she's lying. Naughty to girl. Okay, let's have ladies first. Hayley, pick a number between 1 and 10.
Number three.
Now, what are you
here
doing?
Here it is. I was looking at the front. I was looking at
goodness gracious me.
Okay.
Number three, we have.
Here we are, Hayley.
What?
Your hands ready.
Is it?
It's a book.
It's a book, that's correct, yes!
Big round of applause for Hayley. Hayley's got heaps of supporters out there
for
today.
For your bonus point, Hayley, listen to this question. What book gives the correct meaning and spelling of words?
The dictionary.
The dictionary is correct! Yeah! Okay. And now, young Richard, pick a number between 1 and 10.
2.
Number 2.
Number 2.
Yes.
It's heavy, this one.
Right.
Here we go. Are you ready, Richard?
Hammer.
A hammer, yeah!
That was very quick.
Now, Richard, for your bonus point, listen very carefully. Listen carefully. If I dropped a hammer and a golf ball from the same height at the same time, which item would hit the ground first?
Hammer.
The hammer. Oh no, see that's incorrect, Richard, because Newton's law of gravity says that if you drop any two items from the same height at the same time, because of gravity, they'll hit the ground at exactly the same time.
Thanks for that little scientific lesson for today.
Well, I learned that from Professor Watt. Okay, so that's 1 point there for Rich. And Hayley has got 2 points on my calculations, but let's go along for another question.
Yes.
Yes, there we go. Just checking there with the judges. Hayley, next number.
6.
Number 6.
That was a scientific test for me myself, going back many years from my school days. Number 6.
This isn't one of your shoes, is it, Todd?
Oh, I don't believe that, Amanda.
Don't worry, I knew before she said it.
You sure, Hayley?
Yeah,
I'm sorry, I just got carried away then. I really
what
did.
What a silly duffer.
How could I have done that?
Well, this isn't one of your shoes, is it?
I'll have to give Richard a
down on the farm, you crazy
I'll have
woman.
To give Richard
look,
a bit of a hand
now. Hayley, Hayley, I'm trying to read this with a straight face. Here's your bonus point question. Don't know hints, Amanda, fair dinkum. Okay?
My lips are
real. Name the footwear that is worn on many Australian feet during summer. And there's a hint, it sounds like pong.
Pong?
It sounds like pong, it's not pong, it's sounds like pong. Flip flop, flip flop.
Oh, the thong.
The thong! Richard, things are looking good because Amanda's on your team now.
Yeah. I've got to give him
pick a
hint
pick a number,
now.
Big guy.
7?
Number 7.
Go, Hayley! Oh, telephone, eh?
Subtle, Todd. That was me.
No, well, I think it's fair. Shh.
Okay. Shh.
Richard.
It's fair.
Well, it's got to be a telephone.
A telephone?
Yes.
Oh, how did he know?
Hey, that was amazing.
Isn't that amazing? Yeah, that's fair now. See, you're going with the girls, I'm going with the boys. You're cheeky. Okay, your bonus point question, Rich. Here we go. In case of emergency, what telephone number should you call to get help?
Police.
Hmm?
Police.
Police. Let's assume you are calling the police. What telephone number is that? And well, there's 3 digits in there, Richard. 3 digits.
You're not.
What?
Not.
Not one naught. Nope, that's one wrong. It's 000 000. Ding dong.
Ding dong.
Is that the end of the game? No, it's not. It's just a ding dong noise. Okay. Hayley, pick another number between 1 and 4. 1 and 4.
Number 4. Okay. I'm not giving any more hints to you, Hayley.
Hayley's a little bit in front here, Rich. Good luck. Another one coming your way after this.
Here we are, Hayley. Easy, they're saying.
It's one of those puncher things.
It's one of those puncher things. It is a puncher thing. It's a paper punch. Correct. Okay, here we go, Hayley. For your bonus question, bonus point. What is the main raw material used in making paper?
Bark, tree bark, sort of.
Tree bark. Oh, that's pretty close. It's actually wood. I guess that's correct. Yes, Hayley, correct. Okay, Richard. Hayley's on 6. Ooh, and Richard's on 2. Mate, if you can get 4 points
on,
out
Richard.
Of this 2 points, you've got a good chance. Richard, pick a number, buddy.
Oh, 3.
3. 3 it is, yes. 3. No, we've done 3.
No,
pick
we've
another
done
one.
3.
Oh, 10.
10?
10.
Okay.
No, we've done 10.
No, we haven't done 10, yes. Gee whiz. Amanda, what did you have for breakfast this morning?
I don't know. I was having a really bad
What did you have for lunch this afternoon?
Okay, here we are, Richard.
Strange girl.
I heard that.
No, I didn't.
I did. Oh, it's a coat hanger.
Coat hanger, yeah!
Yes!
Oh, and Richard, for your bonus point. Now listen carefully, Rich, okay? In what piece of furniture would you commonly find coat hangers?
Piece of furniture.
What piece of furniture? You know, like a
wardrobe.
A wardrobe is correct. Richard, yeah! And I think that's... There's the gong. That's all we have time for. Take your blindfolds off and let's have a score check. Here on Kids Company.
It was pretty close.
Richard 4. Hayley is our winner for today. Congratulations, Hayley. Richard, you'll be getting a great Milton Bradley game. Every single game is absolutely the best. Okay, thanks for playing What Is It? Hayley, you've got that Hanamax thingy going on. It's up and running too.
Oh, and she is excited.
She's so happy.
She just can't stop jumping.
Are you happy? Would you like to say hello to anybody at this point in time?
No. Hello to everybody I know.
Oh, she's famous. Isn't that marvellous? Thanks for joining us. This was What Is It? And we're going to a break now?
We are.
Oh, very good.
We'll see you again soon.
Soon.
We didn't keep you in the dark about that one. Back soon with some of the best jokes you've heard.
Type people. Okay, this is the audience input section, jokesters, and of course with every joke we need a judge. Yes, we do. Today's judges are as follows. David, look. David, you're our judge. Matthew, he's our chief judge. I'll put him in charge. I hope the stress doesn't knock him out. And Rebecca, you look beautiful today. You're a judge as well, okay? Judges will be giving scores between 1 and 5 as quickly as they possibly can. Let's find some jokesters. Come on. Young Sarah's up here on the back row. She reckons she's got a beauty for me. Coming through, lady with a pram. Come on now, guys. Yeah, here we go. Oop, sorry about that, broken foot. Sarah, before you tell me your joke, did you know that every jokester today was going to get one of these? A Hungry Jack's voucher for a Whopper. Did you know that? And they're in my pocket, but they just don't want to come out because they want to stay with me. Look at that. Ew. Yes. Sarah, it's in front of your face. Ooh. Okay. Hold on to it and tell me your joke.
Knock, knock, who's there?
Oh, you've got me. Let's try it a bit slower, shall we? Let you say knock, knock, and I'll say who's there, okay?
Knock, knock.
Who's there?
Get me out of here, I'm cold.
Oh, it's a trick one. It's one of those ones you have to think about. But it's worth a whopper, don't you think, out there at left me cold. Anyway, here we go. Judges, what do you think, judges? 2, 3, and 1. Yeah, well, I would say so myself. Knock, knock, who's there? She threw me on that one. It's a punchline as well, you know. Next jokester, hands in the air. Where's the colourful? Come on, you colourful people with... Amber, yeah. Amber, sorry, judges. Joke.
What do you call a sleeping bull?
What do you call a sleeping bull? I don't know.
Bulldozer.
A bulldozer. Your Hungry Jack's Whopper looking good. And the judges, David, Matthew and Rebecca. Oh my goodness, it's a clean sweep. A bulldozer, 15 points. 15 points. Yes, come on. That's fantastic. Katie, that wasn't a bad joke, guys, you know. Katie, your joke.
What's small, yellow and dangerous?
Oh, I don't know, but yes, my mind boggles. Small, yellow and dangerous.
A canary with a... machine gun.
A canary with a machine gun. Okay, come on, judges. Got me. Okay, a canary. Three, and an upside down 4. A correct way 4. That's fantastic, Dave. Okay, there's your Hungry Jack's Whopper there, Katie. You lucky girl. Front row. Young Tracy.
Knock, knock.
Here we go. Who's there?
Lettuce,
who? I know.
Let us in.
There you go, the winner, isn't it? There we go. Have a look at the judges. What do you reckon? Judges, let us in. Come on. Five. Oh, geez, I'll tell you what, Matthew's a bit mean there, isn't he? 5, 1, and 2. All right, okay. Hey, Nathan, looking good in the red there, big guy. What's your joke?
Why can't Cinderella play football?
No idea.
She keeps running away from the ball.
I like that. That's original. There you go, your Whopper voucher, mate. Judges, what do you reckon? 5, 5 and 4. Ooh, a close one. That's pretty good. Where's our next jokester? He's cool. We've got a couple up the back shelf there, but fair dinkum, I'm not quite sure if I can get there. I'm getting old. Rebecca, what's yours?
Where do ducks play cricket?
Yes. I know this one, but I can't say it. Where do ducks play cricket?
At the Quacker.
At the Quacker. Yeah, I love it. What do you reckon, folks? Is that a good joke?
Yeah!
Panel of judges, 4, 3 and 3. Or 5, 3 and 3. Oh, make up your mind there, Rebecca. It was something 3 and 3. Now, let me sort of climb up into the cubs here. Yeah, uh-oh, look out. Move your Jonathan Skeet sunglasses and Koala Beach sunglasses. Look out. I'll come back to you if I've got time. Excuse me, darling. Oh, there we go. Okay, Scott. See? Scott. What's your joke?
What's black and white and red?
What's black and white and red? Tell me, Scott.
A zebra driving a red Ferrari.
A zebra driving a red Ferrari. I don't know how he could afford it myself. How the Cubs like it. Panel of judges, let me have a look. Panel, what have we got? Oh, upside down too, yes! There you go, there's a red Ferrari whizzing past. Yeah, okay, we've got another joke over here, didn't we? Okay, big long stretch, what's your joke?
What's the difference between you and Kenny Kidna?
What's the difference between me and Kenny Kidna? You be very careful.
Kenny Kidna's got more friends.
We paid her to say that.
I have to give her one of these, you know that, don't you? I have to. Here, Lisa, for joy. You know, I hope at Christmas, she's really happy she said that now, I'm really upset. I hope for Christmas she gets exactly what she deserves, like the cold or something, a flu or something. Panel of judges, well, I didn't think it was worth much. Yeah, good on you, judges, I love you. 4, 1 and 2. Next, let me see, I need one of those. Sit down, all you cubs. You're spitting me out. One more. Here we go. Have you got one? Yeah, Terry. We'll go to Terry here. Terry's the middle shelf. Terry, it better not be anti me or you're in strife. Terry, what's your joke?
What do you get when you sit under a car?
Extremely flat. I don't know. What do you get when you sit under a car?
Cow.
What? What do you get when you. Oh, what do you get when you sit under a cow? Sorry, pronunciation, Terry. Cow. Okay? What do you get when you sit under a cow?
A pat on the head.
A pat on the head. Hey, I like that. That one reminds me of Kenny Kidna. Okay, let's have a look. The panel of judges have gone for the big scores of 3, 5 and 4. All of our jokesters that I didn't get to will also get Hungry Jack's vouchers, which is excellent on the show. And now, the winning joke. Envelope, please. Amber, come with me. Come on, camera 2. That's Artistic Andy's on camera 2, aren't you, Andy? Yes, way to go. Where's Amber? Amber, look, I'm going to give you this joke. Compliments of Milton Bradley. It's a trouble game, and it's a winner. Yes, round of applause for Amber. Come on. And everybody gets goodies today. Take a look at these.
Oh, delicious goodies, which Amanda is getting into. Gee, they're greedy guts. You get Coca-Cola, you just can't beat the feeling. Also, superb chocolates and sweets from WA's Bates Confectionery. And Twisties, Amanda, you guts. Oh, Amanda. Oh, sorry. And also, great Cocky Circle books. Delicious food and those great books. Now, if you'd like to come in and be part of our studio audience, Amanda, put that back. Send it on the back of an envelope, your name, your age between 6 and 12 years, your address and your telephone. Oh, what a guts! Telephone number on the front, send it to audience.
Nice.
Care of Kids Company, Post Office Box 422, Mirrabooka, Western Australia, 606... We're back with the party games. This is Connect Four.
You know, those studio audience, they don't sit still. They yell, they scream, they cheer like this, they wave.
They do, they look like they've got worms. They're always wriggling around.
Oh, that's not a nice thing to say. Who's got worms in the studio audience? Anyone got worms?
Hello, worms.
No.
Yes. Free plug, Combantion, there you go, take it away. This is Connect Four, and we have two heats. Winner of each heat goes into the final to play for the great big prize, which looks and smells like this.
It is a Hanamex. That's my favourite word.
I Hanamex know it is, because you can't say it properly, can you?
I hate saying that word. That is the major prize.
Great product too.
And the runners up will all receive a Connect Four game.
That's right. So the winning prize
Milton
is the Hanamex boombox, and everyone who plays gets a Connect Four game. And you can't even say that properly, too, either, can you, Amanda?
What's that?
You can introduce the contestants correctly.
Oh, I hope I can too. First, we have Oscar and Sarah.
Great.
Okay, I'll leave you to it. Good luck, guys.
Thank you, Mr. Pledge. Thank you. Sarah, come on in. You've played this game before, haven't you?
Yes.
Are you very good?
Yes.
What school do you go to?
Mount Lawley.
Mount Lawley. And who's your best friend?
Sinead Hughes.
Ah. Say that again.
Sinead.
Oh, right. That's an unusual name, isn't it? Sinead. Oscar, what about you, my friend? What school do you go to?
Jandicott.
Jandicott. All the way from Jandicott you've come up. Well, good on you. Thanks for being on the show. Simple game. Connect Four. Four in a row. You know how to play. It doesn't really need me to say anything. Let's go. Yellow goes first. Oscar!
One, two, three, four. Connect Four.
That's it. Here we go. Oscar and Sarah playing for the right to play in the final.
For the boom box. Yeah.
And everybody, yes, we have red people cheering and yellow people cheering and stuff. Come on, Oscar. Oscar. Oh! Sarah, thank you very much. You've got a great Milton Bradley game. Oscar, come back for the final, OK? Don't miss out. Amanda's in charge. There we go.
Heat two, Connect Four.
Here we are.
Dun, dun, dun,
they are ready for Connect Four. Heat two, Josh and Melissa. And they were going to get right into it, so I'm going to leave you to it.
All right. I love it. Heat two. Always talk to the girls first, Josh. OK, not being rude here. Melissa, school.
Armidale High.
What's the best part about Kids Company? Tell me. Don't say Kenny Kidner or else I may never talk to you again.
Connect Four.
Oh, what a thing to say. Josh, what school are you, mate?
Jandicott.
And what football club do you barrack for, buddy?
Eagles.
The Eagles. Good. Of course, you know that every Friday we have Guy McKenna on the show. Yes, he did know that. Okay, let's get rid of these discs. Because if we don't get rid of them, there's already a Connect Four and yellow has won. There we go. Now sort them out. Come on, kids, now. Come on, now. Stand there like, you know, nothing. This is it. Josh, you're first. Connect Four, Heat Two. Let's go. Start the music.
One, two, three, four. Connect Four.
Tony Bonnie, music sounds good. This is Connect Four. Josh and Melissa. Big moments on Channel 10. And Kids Company. Ooh, it's a Connect Four! Melissa, Josh, thank you very much, mate, for competing. We've got a great consolation prize for you. Bring it. And Melissa, don't you go away.
Don't you go away. You've got to play in the final. In the final, Oscar's back. Oscar's back for the final.
Whoa.
Best of luck, you two.
Yeah, I love it. Thanks. Thank you, Mr. Pledge. Mr. Pledge. Let's get those discs. Come on, sort out those discs there, kids. We have Oscar, winner of Heat 1. Melissa, winner of Heat 2, both playing for the big boom box. Now, there's a bit of a height difference here, but to play Connect Four, the height must be in the brain. That's right, isn't it, Oscar?
Yep.
Okay, let's go with the big final. This is it. Connect Four. Yellow goes first.
One, two, three, four.
Ooh, careful.
Connect Four.
I must admit, I've played this game once or twice, and I've lost every time. Oh. Ooh, yes, yes, think about it. Connect Four, that's it! Yeah. Oscar, thank you very much for playing. Out you go, we've got a Milton Bradley game for you, Connect Four. Hey, Melissa. Now, you did sort of say to me before that, like, this was the favourite game, favourite part of Kids Company. Is it still your favourite game?
Yeah.
You sure?
Yeah.
Okay, and what do you honestly think? Now, think about Kenny, picture him in your mind. What do you think of Kenny Kidner? Is he great? Is he fantastic?
Yeah.
You sure?
Yeah.
Yeah. So quiet, but happy. A happy winner here on Connect 4. And you've won the boombox, a little flash of the boombox for you, just about to take home with you. Excellent stuff. And stick around, there's a lot more Kids Company coming up right now.
Oh, that's right. We'll be back soon with Kenny's Wheel. I can't wait. It's our second birthday on Kids Company. And look at all the people that we invited to the party. Hang on, I don't remember inviting her. Oh, we invited him though.
It's party time. Let's party. Want to dance, Amanda?
Dance at party?
Want to dance? It's party time.
I'd love to dance with you, Kenny.
Hey. Okay, let's dance.
I'm deaf.
Oh, no,
oh good.
I've lost my hearing.
You're not mute.
They screamed too loud. The audience made too much noise.
They're a great audience, aren't they?
Do it again.
Oh, I can't hear you. I'm sorry. I'm deaf.
Hey, Todd.
What?
I've got a question for you.
Oh, I just answered him.
I've got a question for you.
What is it?
You know when you're doing that, what is it? And you're talking about things falling down at the same speed.
Yeah. Mm.
Wasn't Newton.
It wasn't Newton's law.
Do you know who it really
Newton's
was?
Newton's law of gravity, wasn't it?
No. It's Galileo Galilei.
Was he?
Yeah, my teacher rang up and said, tell Todd he did it wrong. I thought I'd better tell you.
I think he's released a single, hasn't he? Galileo Galilei.
Yeah, I think he did too. It was from 1564 to 1642.
Well, I thought it was Newton's law of gravity. It doesn't matter. Look, no. you check with your teacher on that one, okay? A golf ball and a hammer, drop them at the same time.
Galileo, Galileo.
All I know is they hit the ground at the same time.
They do. You're right on that one, Todd.
Thank you very much, Ed Ken. Let's have a contestant for Kenny's World.
Yes. Teacher rang up, you know.
I got my hearing back. Okay. Where's she going? Where's Amanda?
Oh, she's off again. She's always off.
Kenny.
I didn't mean it like that. I mean, you're always going
places. Over there.
Hey, Michelle.
This is Michelle.
Michelle, my bell.
Michelle, this is Kenny. Say hello.
Hi.
Hi, Michelle. I bet you go to school.
Yep.
Did anyone ever pull your pigtails?
No.
No, you whack them if they do. What's the name of your school?
Mercy.
Mercy. That's what I say around here all the time to Todd. Have mercy. Have mercy. But he never listens.
You're cute, Mr. Kidner.
Hey, when you grow up and become a big person like Todd, what do you want to do?
A fashion designer.
Ooh. You could design Brent some new shirts because he needs them.
His
grandmother will send you the fabric.
I've got some good curtains you can cut up, actually.
I think you've cut up all your curtains. He's starting on his bed sheets now. Would you like to get someone out of the barrel there, Michelle?
Well, you don't have to get anyone out of the barrel, Michelle. What you need to do is get an envelope out of the barrel. Normally I say get someone out of the barrel.
That barrel's pretty suspicious. There's always someone in there. Or something.
Come here, Michelle.
It's
Aztec
camera.
Michelle's sitting back going, oh no, I don't want to put my hand in there.
She's scared.
Give me
your
left hand
the back of the neck.
And close your eyes. Close your eyes, Michelle. Here we go. Now. In goes the hand.
Huck new, huck new. It's a brabru moonlit nick.
Guy McKenna, get out of the barrel. Guy McKenna in
it's
the barrel.
It's Papa McScott.
Okay, come here. Papa come here, Michelle. Because Kenny, you know, he looks good. We need to see him. Okay.
Oh, thanks, Todd.
That's okay there, big guy. The name is just simply Tram. T-R-A-M, age 6. Hello.
Hello, Tram,
age 6, and he's from Girraween. So, Tram, if you're out there in Girraween, you are going to be a co-pilot here for Michelle, and you've both got the chance of winning these prizes, Brent. Tell us.
That's right. I hope you don't fall off the tracks, Tram. If Kenny's Wheel stops on the Archie Martin logo, our winners will receive a personal stereo cassette recorder and an animated message alarm clock. Love that one. And a solar-powered calculator. Plus Times Atlas of the World Family Edition, all with the compliments of Archie Martin. And if it lands on the Channel 10 logo, you get to win the new SodaStream. It's an instant soft drink maker. The carnival model features family and diet flavours. Better tasting soft drinks made at home from SodaStream.
Yummy, yummy.
Or from Billabong, the Australian clothing company. A gift voucher for Billabong beach and casual wear. Billabong, Australian since 1973. From Bets and Vets, the news and shoes especially for you. A gift voucher enabling you to select from Bets and Vets' large range of fashion shoes. From Bets and Vets, the news and shoes. From Roadshow Home Video, a selection of videos featuring the Care Bears, Pound Puppies, and the History of the Ashes with the compliments of Roadshow Home Video. And from Rollerdrome Balcata, a pair of Zenith speed skates with a lifelong guarantee on plate breakage. Great for a quick spin around Rollerdrome Balcata.
Yeah.
I've seen a band use these too, by the way.
Hey, hey, hey.
Yeah. Michelle, are you into sort of rap music and stuff like that?
Yeah.
You know when they go, woo?
Yeah. Amanda does rap music, woo, don't you, Amanda?
Yeah.
No, I don't.
Go on, do a rap for us now, Amanda.
No. Yeah.
Birthday rap.
I saw her rapping lunches earlier on.
Pardon?
I saw you rapping lunches earlier on.
No, she does a great rap version of Christmas too. It's very, very good.
She does a country rap. Tell us about Jethro.
No, come on. Kenny, Mr. Pledge.
Oh, right.
Mr. Pledge, she's saying, I'm going to get you, kid. Now you're in the big trouble. Michelle, this is your big moment on Kenny's wheel. You like rap music, we've established that, so whoop, yeah, and good luck. Come over here to this side of the wheel, and when you're ready, spin it as hard as you can.
Yo!
Where do you think it's going to land, Amanda?
It just might land on the Channel 10 logo.
Caroline.
Let's hope so. That's unfortunate, isn't it, Amanda?
It is.
For a great consolation prize, Kenny's got to ask you a question.
Okay, Michelle, my bell. Shh, quiet out there in the peanut gallery. Here we go. Name the odd one out, and it's a tricky one, so be careful. A felt-tip pen, a ballpoint pen, or a chicken pen?
Chicken pen.
Good one, Michelle!
Michelle, you have won a great Milton Bradley consolation prize, and so also has Tram of Girraween. You sure you wouldn't like to do a rap thing now, Miss Amanda?
No, I wouldn't.
Amanda, what about you, Kenny? Can you do a rap?
Yeah, you show us a rap.
Oh, okay. I'm really glad to be here, guys, and open your eyes, and I think
I'll give you a surprise.
It's not going too well, is it,
Todd? No, that'll do, Ken. Thanks so much. Listen, if you want to be a part of Kenny's wheel, and you don't have to rap or anything, just send in an envelope to this address.
Well, hi there, guys. I'll put you to the test. Here is the Kenny's wheel address. Send it to Kenny's wheel. I like that one. Care of Kids Company, Post Office Box 422, Mirrabooka, Western Australia 6061. On the back, put your name and address just so we can find you again. And now, here's over to Mr. Todd.
Woo! Yeah. Woo! Okay, studio audience behind me, getting ready for the funny faces. It's back this week. Funny faces, okay? You ready, studio audience?
Yeah!
I said, are you ready?
Yeah!
Gee whiz.
Okay, come on over here. This is Ricky Raffici on camera 3.
Oh,
geez, I'll tell you what, he hit me. Ricky, I'd like to ask a small favour here.
Yep.
How long have you been on camera?
What, today?
Not today. Oh. Well, how long have you been on camera like for your entire life, Rick?
I don't know.
About 47 years now?
Yeah, close.
Ask him a simpler question, what's his name?
Is it hard to do camera again?
But what's not his name?
No, depends.
I want to have a go. Can you compare the show for the next, three minutes or something?
If you can do it, I can do it.
Well, okay, now just show us this thing here.
On you, Ricky.
Okay, now I've got inside these things here, which are called cans, is the producer, director. Say hello. There we go, we just heard his voice. Little tiny man. And
how does he
I'm
get
have
in those
a go
cans?
Here. Now Ricky's comparing, okay? How do I work this, mate?
You got your focus there and your zoom. Yeah, they're right.
Yeah.
Right, yep. Turn your wheels.
Oh, wheels.
Thigh bones connected to the knee bone.
Funny
the knee
faces.
Bone's connected to
funny
the
funny faces, yeah, you got
here we go, funny faces, roll out the barrel. It's the camera carousel. And there's some beautiful green hats and green tongues out there.
Bad,
oh, no. How can you breathe when you've got your fingers up your nose like that? Look, Luna Park. Oh, Todd. Be careful. Make us all dizzy. It's the camera carousel. Up we go and down we go. Up we go. Zoom in, Todd. Zoom in. Zoom in.
He doesn't know how.
No, I don't think he does either. Some very lovely teeth there. They've all been taking advice from our dental therapist last week. She was great. She'd be proud of these
it's
teeth.
Stuck. Hi, Todd.
That's a funny face. Oh, that's a lampshade. Don't break the camera.
He's having a hard time, folks. Please forgive him.
Oh, no, look at that. Sky Channel was here.
Very blurry, Todd.
Oh, see, his eyes look pretty blurry.
Yeah.
Todd.
You can't just let the camera go, Todd.
Okay, how was that? Was that fantastic?
Not
what do you think?
Garlic. Yay!
Do you think I'm better than Ricky?
No!
Well, listen, I thought I did a pretty good job there. Was it your funny face, David, that I zoomed in on? I think it was.
Can't
FM,
remember.
I've got to check because I'm not quite sure. I was having too much fun. Dave, you were a judge before, but now you've got the funniest face in the entire world. Your eyes are red, your ears are red, your eyes are leaking, his nose is leaking, and for that, we're going to give him a Milton Bradley game. It's called Kerplunk. Okay? Thanks very much. And audience, we have to go. So let's say goodbye to Kenny and Amanda. Bye. Thanks.
Bye, everybody.
See you, Amanda.
Brent. We're going to say goodbye to Brent.
Okay, bye, Brent.
Oh, see you later, everybody. What did everyone think of Todd's camera work? What score would you give him?
Zero.
Hey, listen, I'm getting out of here. Bye.
My kind of kids.
See you later. What a great birthday party. Fashions by Maya. Shoes by Bets and Bets, the news and shoes.
Happy birthday to us.
Here by Clues,
happy
thanks for all that. And those great games from Milton Bradley. Wonderful games as our production team. We'll be back tomorrow. Hopefully Todd won't touch the camera. Oh, hope not.
Dear, could be worse. Awful. Could have been Brent.
It could have been. Could have been better.
Damn it.
What a great day. Don't forget to join us tomorrow on Kids Company. Some wonderful stuff coming up, including a very interesting act and some good cartoons too. Kids Company has been a production of Channel 10 Perth. Fred Mayer speaking. Catch you tomorrow.
Hello.
Ah, being attacked. Please, no closer. Back. Oh, dear.
What a face.
Thank you.